Fellow Cravers, and welcome to the CTG Podcast for Wednesday, the 10th of February 2016. It is episode 80. As always, you have me, GD, you have Cajr, you have Shimmy, and we have the return of Doc. Hey!
Hey!
How is everybody today? Hope you enjoyed Pancake Day yesterday. I swear to hell did. I had strawberries and cream. For some weird reason, it came up in a comment.
Tasty.
Yeah, it was nice actually. Yeah, I'm not usually a fruit person, but it was nice on a pancake. So, Doc, how are you, mate? We haven't seen you since Christmas time.
Yeah, no, I'm doing well. Doing well.
You're
doing
banana. Oh, the cats.
The cats. The cats are there.
One there.
Everyone wants the cats.
Yeah.
Yes. By the way,
which Tom? Hey, Tom.
Hi, Tom.
How you doing, Tom?
Hi, Tom.
Hi. Let's move in to one of the first stories I want to talk about today, as my hat attacks my eyes. Let's talk about GameTrailers.com, who have now shut down after their 13-year run. If people don't know what GameTrailers.com is, it is what used to be the original place to go and see trailers for games before YouTube itself, until they actually moved on to joining YouTube themselves. So yeah, there was a time before YouTube. So did you guys actually ever go to GameTrailers.com itself?
Indeed.
I never know.
You never know.
I just got the game demos and trailers from the old magazines that used to come out for PlayStation 2 and that, and you'd have a demo disc. That's why I used to get my stuff.
Which all pretty much are near dead as well. It's like I went out, and you know, one of the first aisles that you usually go to in a supermarket, it's usually the magazine section, isn't it? And I just looked around there for some weird reason one day, and I noticed that FHM, or For Him magazine, whatever people call it, they've actually closed shop as well.
Yeah, no, they're finished now.
Yeah, well, a lot of things have changed. It's like there was a story a couple of months back as well about Playboy. No more nudes in their magazine anymore as well. You know, the one thing that a lot of people, when they hear Playboy, the thing that they think about, they're not doing anymore.
I just think about the really interesting articles and the girls that have really smart ideas.
Yeah.
Think about the Commonwealth. Don't play too much Fallout.
It's like just the page three, just in a magazine, isn't it?
Yeah, they're really, you know, rowing about the political struggles in other countries, and it's really fascinating to see them.
Surprisingly, most of them probably didn't even hear about that country until they were actually told about it in the article.
Oh, did you hear about the earthquake?
No, which one?
The Cockneys.
I've got really big boobs.
You're Welsh.
But, yeah.
It's a sad time, isn't it? But everything's digital now, isn't it? So I can't see kids today. I used to go and get me WWF magazine.
They still do WWE magazines now.
Yeah, and me PlayStation. Then it was PlayStation 2 magazine with a little disc in.
I used to have, I think the first magazine that I ever got was, do you remember something called PlayStation Max?
Yeah.
With the dog on, the dog as its mascot, which I'm thinking nowadays, I don't even remember the name of the dog, I think it was Spike or something like that. And, oh my god. Yeah, I was Donald Trump on page two. first of all, digital, everything is going digital nowadays, and it makes perfect sense. Look at us. We are on YouTube ourselves. It's the new age of entertainment, and it's just going to get bigger and bigger at the moment.
Yeah.
Especially with more and more people and more, especially even our generation, going on to digital formats to get their entertainment. Not many people are watching TV anymore. They're watching things like Netflix and
on demand. People want it now. They don't want to watch adverts about blankets for old people who want to watch. when I watch the shows now, isn't it? You can tailorize your own. You don't think, oh no, when I watch Coronation Street at 7:30, and then I've got to wait till 9 o'clock before Downton Abbey's on. No, you can just say, I want to watch that now. I've got an hour. I'm going to watch everything now, and then bugger off.
Yeah.
Well, I said, like, you used to go down to Blockbusters and like rent a VHS. Yeah, you just sit in your chair and click a few things around.
Order the food on your mobile.
Yeah.
You can even order off your Xbox now on your Xbox One. You can stick on the pizza place on your free Sky credit and then say Xbox Skype or pizza, order your pizza. Are you watching Netflix and chilling?
Yeah. Well, that, you even got that saying came from it. That's one of the newest sayings that have come out this year. Netflix and chill, which means something completely different.
See, but, yeah, I just discussed at work with someone because they were like, oh, you know, Netflix and chill. I was like,
yeah, I know what it means, right?
I do now.
Yeah, just you do now.
I didn't. I generally thought it was just chilling out Netflix and.
I've got to be honest, the first time I actually heard that myself, that was what I thought it was. And then you kind of, when you started hearing certain people saying it, thinking, yeah, it doesn't mean what I'm thinking it's meaning. I think, to be honest, this Game Trailers, going back to GameTrailers.com as well, this is the first time I've heard a digital outlet of news dying out.
Yeah.
Which is it's kind of shocked a lot of people at the same time, because it's basically started so many things in the digital gaming side of things, and it's like it's passing of someone in a family.
Like your granddad dying, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much. 13 years. This is a long time for it. Still,
It's a crowded market now for it, though. There's that many websites and things now. It's just a crowded market.
Well, the closest thing I can think of with Game Trailers compared to anything else that we can find on here that come to mind is probably Machinima. See? Idea. But it's like Machinima, they're probably the newest, biggest area when it comes to that side of things. Or Polaris, another one, who have so many different areas themselves in gaming. It's like, I bet if you check your own YouTube subscriber list, I bet everyone subscribed to at least one or two. As long as you watch gaming things, you probably subscribe to one or two people in that list already.
No, because I get all my information from
Craveville
Game.
I doubt that we better give them any much information. We do it on the podcast.
That's why I don't know what the fuck. That's why I don't know what's going on half the time.
I know what you mean. It's dying now. It launched in 2002. It was an early runner in for video-based gaming coverage. What they did is that editor-in-chief Brandon Jones tweeted that. This was February the 8th, so this was Monday. He tweeted that today is the last day of Game Trailers. I wish it wasn't so. The site was posting its standard fare of video reviews, trailers, and guides right up to the surprising announcement. So this just came out of nowhere as well. I think it was such a surprise that I think the people who are on the YouTube side of it as well didn't know about it until about an hour or two before the actual announcement itself.
By the way, guys, in case you didn't get the memo, we're fucking up.
Sorry?
Sorry.
Well, that's Mike's take on how it would be, by the way, guys, in case you didn't get the memo. Fuck you. You're sacked.
GD's just confused. Don't confuse
the film. Don't confuse me, please.
Last time, Mike, just keep it between us, buddy.
Yeah.
I know where you got it. Yeah, it's only GD that get it.
Yeah. But today's Facebook announcement.
He's just leaving his door.
GD, we can't hear.
Sorry.
I just got no sound coming through. Then.
Good.
I can hear you guys all right. Today's Facebook announcement focused on the growth in Let's Plays and video-based game journalism, which is true. That is where everything is going now. Look at us. We mainly do Let's Plays on our channel. I think it's only the podcast that we do any kind of information, gaming itself, isn't it?
Yeah.
I think the only other thing closest resembles to any information is probably our WWE predictor, but that's a different genre of entertainment in itself, isn't it? Where we talk about the game, or about predictions, which, by the way, that's coming up in a couple of weeks' time again. They said that they're proud we helped bring this world into being. That is the legacy of Game Trailers.
Yeah.
But like I said, Game Trailers was purchased by Define Media in the middle of 2014. Almost immediately, the company imposed layoffs, with more taking place last year. Define Media is also a publisher of The Escapist, among other online destinations. So, that's all the information I got from it. So, RIP Game Trailers, I guess.
Yeah.
I put 2007 for some weird
reason. May you rest in peace with Woolworths. Blockbusters.
For some weird reason, I put in the box at the bottom 2007. It's 2002.
So if you think about it, though, something that had it first, they could have evolved into the YouTube, like Blockbusters could have evolved in... Didn't they say they had a chance to do something like Netflix or buy Netflix out when it first started, but they didn't bother?
Exactly. This is the thing. Like, they probably did have the opportunity. The thing is, they were the people who pioneered the path to things like, the side of YouTube that we mainly focus on ourselves.
Yeah.
And like you said, with Blockbusters, if it wasn't probably for Blockbusters, we probably wouldn't have things like Netflix and Amazon Prime itself. Because
have seen the thing and evolved quickly and jumped on the bandwagon where they've stayed. Oh no, that'll never take off. Who wants to watch stupid videos on the internet? We're just doing game trailers. We're not putting random people playing games on. That's a stupid idea.
Well, it's like, look at gaming now, looking compared to Netflix as well. Look at gaming nowadays. We're getting things like PlayStation Now. EA of doing their PC version of EA Access, aren't they? EA Origins Access or something like that.
Something long-winded and shit.
Long-winded and shit, yeah. But even Ubisoft are thinking of doing it as well, where they are going to be doing like a subscription service for their gaming. And it's like another place that I've noticed this week as well. Humble Bundle. They have a monthly subscription thing now as well.
Yeah, you get a game a month, don't you?
Yeah, I think it's Ark at the moment. Yeah. It's Ark at the moment, yeah.
So remember it was Alien Isolation last month or something like that?
Something like that. But the thing is, games are going into the subscription side as well. I don't think it's going to be anywhere near as big as movies.
She can see what she wants.
Like I said, I don't think it's going to be anywhere near as big as movies. Because movies, they make sense for a subscription because there's always been a movie rental service, hasn't there? Like we're saying with Blockbusters, there's not really been a gaming rental service out there which really took off.
Well, that's it. You could do it with Blockbusters, couldn't you? But
then again, people, when they think Blockbusters, what do they think? They think movies. They don't think, this is where I rented my game.
Yeah, but that was before the big boom of the video games, really.
That was a good way of trying games before.
Yeah, it was a good way of demoing them, but most people bought the games, or in PS1 version state, usually got a chip PlayStation and got them all down.
Yeah.
Which we do not recommend. I'm just saying.
We was young.
Otherwise, places like this shut down because you don't support them. And then wonder why. Oh, why did it shut down? It's because nobody could watch.
No one actually bought it. Do you know why games probably going to be shutting down? It's not because of this. People are buying it digitally. Even though it's the same bloody price.
Which is why renting games, you might as well rent them now because you don't own the bloody thing you pay for anyway now.
Billy comes out with a good one here. We already pay for a subscription, PS Plus and Xbox Live. Yeah, but you're paying to play online.
You're paying to play online. That's a different thing, though. I think PlayStation's closest thing isn't PlayStation Plus. Okay, you get at least two free games from PlayStation Plus for the PS4, don't you, each month?
Yeah.
And Xbox, you get four now thanks to backwards bloody compatibility. But yeah, it's just I don't see it taking off as much. I think it would work better for a PC outlet than a console.
Yeah.
Depends what the catalogue is, doesn't it? I mean,
I think it's looking at PlayStation now. I don't think many people are actually jumping on board with that. I think this is the closest thing that we're going to get from
that. It's quite a lot of money for...
It's only £3, isn't it?
Sorry?
Is it £3 a month?
What, PlayStation Now?
No, it's like £12 a month.
It's about £12 EA Access or something.
I don't know about EA Access. EA Access, but that's different. I think with that, you do get... they have got the Vault, which, by the way, you've got Madden 16 as its newest game in there.
Yeah. Well, so what's PlayStation Now again? What games do they offer?
PlayStation Now have a lot of its...
Last of Us, Walking Dead Season 2.
Yeah, a lot of PS3.
God of War games, Saints Row games.
It's got... it's weird. They've got some that you can get on the subscription, and you've got some that you can only rent.
Yeah.
Which, that's another thing. It's got like a rental service in it as well.
Oh, I rent it.
Yeah, but which is about £4.
The thing about renting a game is, how are they going to enforce it sort of thing? Is it going to be, do you have it a certain amount of time? Or do you have it hours to play?
Yeah. Like, as soon as you only get, like you would Blockbuster, you get it for 3 days or whatever it is.
Yeah.
Yes, so with your movie, it's over in 2 hours.
Yeah, but the deal.
You can take it back. With a game, you might not even scratch the surface some games in 3 days if you don't have the time.
Well, which one did you guys go with? Did you go with Netflix first, or did you go with Amazon first? Or have
Netflix
you got
first.
Netflix none first. Of, none of them. Well, I went with Amazon, but I went when it was Love Film.
Yeah.
All right.
We had it so that they actually sent the disc to your through the post as well.
How did that work?
It worked pretty well. So you basically watch the video and then you send it back. I think you pay like a monthly subscription of it. It's the same price.
Yeah, like depending on your subscription plan.
I'd love to watch a film right now. Oh yeah, watch this one, and then I've got to wait two days for it to come in the bloody post. And then you're like, I can't be arsed watching it now.
Yeah, well, it's not just that. They also had a gaming side of it as well, which I tried out for a bit. Well,
I remember renting a couple of games from Blockbusters back in the day. To try before you buy.
Yeah, that's the way you could do it. It's, like I said, that's why I don't think it will work. Because it's a nice idea for smaller games. So, for example, like the indie side of games, where you've got probably about 2-3 hours of playing, it works perfectly fine. But bigger games like, for example, Skyrim, GTA 5, the huge AAA games, which focus mainly on story, renting just doesn't make any sense for it, because you will not be able to complete that game.
That's it.
Unless
you hammer it. You've actually got to binge through the game.
But the same with like Battlefield and stuff like that. You know, you're going to start playing it online, then you've got to stop.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
And then it's like,
and what happens?
Your choice is either you buy the game or you rent it. Again, and like... Oh, no.
And then what happens when DLC comes out? Are you going to re-rent it? When DLC comes out, you re-rent it. But do you have to pay? What do you have to pay for the DLC though?
Yeah, because you probably won't get the DLC on the disc.
Right.
I think the only times that you probably get DLC on the disc is if it's a Game of the Year edition, and then you're still waiting probably for another year for the game just for the DLC to be added to it. Which that's why I don't think it works. So
I've got. I'll be right back in a minute. My daughter's been out.
Yeah.
Another thing about video games is, because most games require so many hours, people like to come back to them.
Yeah.
Whereas a film, like I say, 3 hours watching the film, you're done. You might not watch it till you might take it back the next day sometime, if you can, or whatever. So, again, it's different because it's our own time and it's what we feel like. If we don't feel like playing, say, I don't know, The Witcher 3, story-based game, if we just want to play MP for a bit on a different game, that game's still being sat there, your time's running out of it, sort of thing.
Yeah.
It's like you're forcing you to play that game if you rent it.
I see. You want to put as many hours in as you can to get your money's worth, and then you don't finish it. You take it back, and then you're just stuck there.
It's just... Anyway, let's move on to another subject, even though Shimmy's not here at the moment. Let's talk about... yeah, that's a good point. Let's talk about Mad Catz. Have you heard... Well, if you don't know who Mad Catz are the leading... they do a lot of the third-party controllers and stuff like that. I think they're more known for things like Rock Band 4 and the guitar peripherals and stuff like that. Mad Catz have ended up laying off about 37% of its staff in restructure. What I remember hearing about it was that... where they were going to have a meeting or something like that, and about three of their directors ended up leaving, including the CEO of the company, before this meeting. So they had had to completely restructure it before even having this meeting about them not having... there you go. Billy says they make crappy knockoff controllers.
Absolutely, that's what they do.
Yeah, they did. But then again, if it wasn't for Mad Catz and their crappy knockoff controllers, you wouldn't have the whole thing about blaming the controller because it is the crappy third-party controller which is stuck on Turbo.
Oh, Turbo buttons.
Yeah. I remember what game was it? Metal Gear Solid. He actually turned in the game and said, I don't know if you use another turbo button. No, where you're getting tortured. And you have to keep mashing fucking circle out of that for about 90 seconds or something.
The main reason why they're saying they've had to cut quite a lot of staff was because they were also backing behind Rock Band 4. Which came out at the end of last year, which unfortunately didn't do that well against Guitar Hero Live. No. I think what damaged them the most, a lot of people still had their old instruments.
Yeah.
so people didn't end up buying the little siblings controller, that's it. Thanks, Billy. Rock Band 4 co-publisher Mad Catz undertaking a corporate restructuring, blah, blah, blah. The company announced today in its earnings report for the third quarter of its 2016 fiscal year. During that quarter, which ran from October to December, Mad Catz recorded $65 million in net sales, the second highest in its history. So they did really well. That included strong Rock Band 4 sales. This is completely going against what we're talking about here.
Yeah.
Said new CEO Karen McGuinness, although they were lower than originally forecast.
So they just didn't do as it did well. It did well, but it didn't as well. It did well, but not as well as they were hoping.
Yeah. I know I hate when companies say that. It's like it's like
Call of Duty. If that doesn't sell by the millions, they're gonna go. It's not sold as well. We've only sold 1.5 million, and we're past Christmas now. You know, it's
yeah.
But at the moment, this is what's annoying me.
Every game has expectations, especially with budget. Where you've got budgets and things like. If they've got a game that's had a lot of development put into it,
yeah,
they're gonna expect. They're gonna expect it to do big.
Yeah, well, it's like there was one story that I remember from, I think it was about 2 years ago. Everyone knows that Tomb Raider ended up getting rebooted, didn't it? I think it was one of the best Tomb Raider games that I've ever played, the first one. I've not played Rise of the Tomb Raider yet, unfortunately, because I'm waiting for it to come out on a better system.
Go on, PC.
I need to get a better system first.
Yeah, you do, yeah. You'll put a disc in and be like...
Oh my god, what are you doing? This isn't Sims 4!
No, it'll probably spit it back out and say, this is not a 3.5-inch floppy.
But either way...
That's what it usually gives them.
But either way, I remember a story that was coming
out... Take the 3 out. We're talking about GD here.
They're picking on my computer again.
No, we've been past your computer.
We're not winding your computer up. That's your job.
No, it's the hamster's job.
It's your job to feed the hamster.
Yeah. Well, anyway, I remember that when the original Tomb Raider came out, there was a story at the end of the year talking about that Tomb Raider didn't do well. This
they
game,
have Fallout to compete with.
No, not that Tomb Raider.
Oh, the other one.
The first one in the reboot, where a lot of people were playing it and looking and thinking, this is a great game. I still love the multiplayer. We just finished a series on our YouTube channel playing the Tomb Raider multiplayer because we enjoyed it. It was Xbox One. Okay, it came out free or something like that, I think it was, at one point. So we ended up playing it again. But it was still a great game. I think it was a reboot that was needed. And a lot of people do agree that this reboot to Tomb Raider was probably one of the best reboots that they've seen for a game in ages.
Yeah, absolutely. But
then Square Enix still came out and said, nah, this game did crap. You sold millions upon millions of it. You cannot call it crap.
It probably never sold as well as it originally did when it first came out, but it was a new IP then that got a lot of hype, wasn't it? So.
Yeah, but when it first came out, I don't expect it to do that well because, okay, we're UK, we're all British. So when it comes to a game that has been made in Britain, we always think, oh, this is a game that was a staple in our society. Tomb Raider being one of them, GTA, well, that's a different story because, come on, that is a great game to the whole world.
Yeah.
But things like Little Big Planet and other things like that, because they're UK-based, we hear a lot about them here, especially at other expos and that lot, because it's usually the stuff that comes to those expos because they're local. And I understand that Tomb Raider, it was extremely popular when it came out on the PlayStation. It was, people can argue that she was one of the mascots for PlayStation.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, and Crash Bandicoot.
Yeah, when you thought PlayStation, you thought Tomb Raider.
Well, it's not just that. Tomb Raider, she's done so much for the gaming community as well, because if it wasn't for her, we probably wouldn't have as many games that have a strong female protagonist in it.
I think we would
as well, bad films.
I think we would. Yeah. We would have games with strong female protagonists. It's just everyone, she was the first.
Well, she was the second.
Well, the second, whatever. Like I said, we would because...
We've got to say second because you know who will shout at you if you said that she was the first.
Who was the first?
Samus.
Who?
Metroid chick.
Yeah, but you don't know that's a woman.
You do? She reveals herself... plus boobs.
In which one?
In the first one. At the end of the game of the first Metroid, she reveals herself as Samus.
She's
hardly feminine.
I don't know. Have you seen the latest Metroid game?
I don't know. I had Metroid on the DS when it first came out.
I mean, you say if it weren't for her, we wouldn't have female. I think we would because of all the equality and things that we have in society nowadays.
Yeah, so but I don't think we would have as many as we do now. I think
we would, because you look at each female protagonist now, they're not many of them really based on Lara Croft. Mm. Bayonetta's not completely different, not based on Lara Croft. I can't think of any anymore, that's the only one I think of.
We use a female person, like Lara Croft.
Well, it's not just that, I think as well, I think, wasn't she the first video game character who was seen as a sex symbol as well?
Yeah. I remember all that. I remember the lie people got told and saying there was a secret scene in one at Tomb Raiders where you could see her naked or something.
There was a cheat as well. I remember they said that there was a cheat of that.
Yeah, cheat. There were a way of doing it. No, I never played Tomb Raider, so I can actually safely say I never even tried it.
I can safely say that there wasn't one.
Oh, I knew there wasn't one, but I can safely say I didn't try it.
But yeah, it's that's what's bugging me. we kind of got off topic here, haven't we? But
yes.
What was talking about? We're talking about Mad Catz.
Yes.
Saying that Rock Band 4 still did well. I agree. It was great. I think it was the right time for things like Rock Band 4 and Guitar Hero to come back again. Because I think it had been, what, 5-6 years or something like that before, since we had another Rock Band Guitar Hero game. And I think they did the right thing where they decided, you know, we're just going to bring one game out and that's it. You do not need another game. There you go. And they did do that perfectly. They said lower than the ballooned. Yeah, ballooned. Lower than expected sales of Rock Band 4 left more inventory on shelves, which led retailers to offer discounts that resulted in lower margins for Mad Catz. During an investor's call this afternoon, Chief Financial Officer David McCohen said that Rock Band 4 performed well in October and November, but added that sales slowed, particularly after Thanksgiving. I'm going to be honest here, probably a lot of game sales slowed after Thanksgiving because it was Christmas time. Look at the charts.
Thanksgiving's not Christmas.
Yeah, but after Thanksgiving, it was pretty much Christmas. It was December, wasn't it? Which is, to a lot of people, that whole month is Christmas.
You even
Christmas.
Turkey, bro.
It's turkey every day. I won't be lying, I had turkey yesterday.
Turkey pancakes.
Turkey pancakes. Mad Catz co-produced the game. Is also they also produced its new PlayStation 4 and Xbox One instrument controllers. Yeah, I think that's what caused a lot of it, because they had the that you could use the old instruments as well. A lot of people.
How did that work with the new layout?
Well, sorry. No, you're thinking the Guitar Hero.
Yeah.
Guitar Hero, you needed a new instrument. Rock Band, you didn't, because they had the old layout on Rock Band.
All right, yeah, no one wants to buy a new one then if you already got one.
No.
Yeah, because the set was quite expensive anyway, wasn't it? No.
But, they reorganized the company, more than $5 million a year starting in the first quarter of the fiscal 20, blah, blah, blah. But they're also bringing out a new controller themselves, which a lot of people thinking are going to be good. Because then we've got Street Fighter V coming out in the next couple of weeks.
They'll make a stupid joystick thing for that.
Yeah, they're going to make an actual control, a tournament joystick for that. Which
that's like 100 quid.
Yeah. So,
play a game. Christ.
Yeah. But, I have no idea what's happening with Mad Catz.
It's cheap crap anyway, really, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
Just cheap copies of things.
It's third-party stuff. They do have some good stuff at the time. Like, for example, the guitar, Rock Band guitars and that lot. They are the official controllers, in the end, are Mad Catz controllers. And I would say the gaming joysticks are quite useful as well. They do... If they weren't useful, they would not be used in Evo tournaments and stuff like that, would they?
Put it this way, Mad Catz guitar, yeah? How many strings does it have?
How many strings does a... You don't need... Well, unless you're playing Rocksmith.
Yeah, but they don't make Rocksmith controllers.
No, well, I doubt they make Rocksmith controllers because that's an actual guitar.
I know, that's what I mean. I don't think Mad Catz have dipped the toes into the guitar industry.
Give them a chance.
Guitar making.
Unless it's plastic and got buttons.
Yeah.
I've still got my original Guitar Hero one. From many, I took it all apart, sanded down all the connectors so they were more responsive and everything. Awesome. Wallpapered it up the front so it has a nice fancy scratch plate. It still works.
I've just saw a story on here that I want to talk about, especially with Doc being here as well. The first Oculus Rift PC bundle has been announced, which you can pre-order from the 16th.
Is that the Dell one?
It is the... It doesn't say Dell.
No, sorry. I remember hearing about Dell doing one.
Oh, it's Asus. Yeah, so it's Dell.
Yeah.
It's Asus, Alienware, and Dell.
Yeah, because Dell and Alienware, sorry.
So the first computer certified as being compatible with the Oculus Rift will be available for pre-order starting from February the 16th. In bundles with the headset, Oculus VR announced today. First of all, Duarte, we've not had you since they've actually announced the price of this thing.
No.
£499.
Yes.
Do you think it is worth it for an Oculus Rift?
Absolutely. More to the fact that they're not actually making profit on it.
That's what they say.
Well, yeah, you can't take them for what they say, really, because you don't know.
Can't you make your own?
I think it is. The technology isn't readily available, so you're going to be paying a high price.
Sorry, continue, dog.
Hmm?
The thing is, I think that's what took me back a little bit, was the shock of how much that they said about it. But then they said that people who've got the second developer kit or something like that, they're going to get it for free or something.
First one.
Sorry?
It's the Kickstarter set. You get
Kickstarter
it free.
Set. You're going to get it free. Which I think if that was cheaper, wasn't it?
Is that what
you've got? No, I've got DevKit 2. Missed out on that.
Would you actually buy that from Oculus, or did you just buy it? You did buy it from Oculus.
What's the difference between this and the one that they're going to release then? Can you still use your DevKit 2?
Yeah, I can absolutely still use mine. The one they're releasing now obviously has the full kind of visual quality. Because with the DK2, it's I can't remember the resolution, but it's quite a low. It's a lower resolution.
Yeah.
So everything's a bit blurry, you can't really read words that well. So when I was playing League Dangerous, it's, you can hardly read the words and stuff like that. So
it's still nauseating.
Yeah, it's good, apart from that.
Would you keep that and use that, or would you buy the new one?
I want the new one. I'm not getting it yet, but I will be getting it.
Well, they said last month when they announced the price of the Rift, bundles with an Oculus Ready PC, the Rift headset will start. The PC and a Rift headset will start at about $1,500.
A £1,000 PC and the headset.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah.
I think he was going to save
£100. You don't need much to run it at all.
That's the thing. That's what you. People have been saying that you need a powerful PC. That's what a lot of the companies have been coming out and saying, that you need a powerful PC to run this, to actually run
it. How? Because it's just a screen? Motion sensor?
You're basically attaching a monitor to your face. With motion, with gyroscopes, isn't it? Yeah. That is basically what an Oculus Rift is.
Like, my PC's ready.
Yeah.
Well, so I'm running a GeForce 970. And stuff like that. So it's quite a powerful PC, but I'm pretty sure you can go with lower.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Probably more scaremongering.
Well, they said that the packages will include a PC, of course, the Rift itself, and everything that comes with the headset. So that is the Oculus Remote, an Xbox One controller, and the copies of Eve Valkyrie and Lucky's Tale. That's another thing. It's not going to be coming with the Oculus controller. It is going to come with an Xbox controller instead. Because that's coming separately now?
Yes.
Which is it supposed to be...
It's motion control.
It's a motion control,
yeah.
So, I don't know. Let's say that pre-orders will begin at 8 a.m. Pacific time on February the 16th. You'll be able to get them from Amazon, Best Buy, and the Microsoft Store. those orders will start shipping in April in limited quantities to selected countries and regions. Oculus said that in a post blog in a blog post. The first batch of Rift headsets will go out March the 28th.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's pretty much and like I said, the initial line of Oculus Ready gaming PCs will include computers from Asus, Alienware, and Dell. So, the same company. They're all the same company.
Yeah.
Oh, or is it Dell?
I don't know about Asus, but I know Dell. Now own Alienware.
Yeah.
Or have done for a very long time.
Yeah. It's a gaming branch, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, they said here that Asus will bring two different models, the G11CD and the ROG G20CB. Alienware does too with its Area 51 and X51 R3. And Dell has won the XPS 8900 Special Edition. Two different versions will be available for both the ROG and the X51. One with an NVIDIA GeForce and a more expensive one with a GTX. So one with a...
What's the number?
One is either a GTX 970 and the other one's a GTX 980.
Yeah, so basically the same as I've got.
Yeah. So in every case, the Oculus...
That was a smug smile he had then after he said that.
Which one have you got? Have you got the smaller one or the bigger one?
970.
The 970. So 980 is the latest one, isn't it?
No, being at the same time.
Oh. What's the point?
The latest one is the Titan.
Oh, God, yeah. I know about the Titan. Yeah, I've seen it.
Beautiful thing.
In every case, the Oculus Ready bundle is cheaper than buying the PC in question, as it suggested retail price and picking up a Rift separately. Well, that's what I expect with a bundle.
Yeah.
Yeah, obviously.
You're not going to buy a bundle and think, oh, you know what, I might be able to get it cheaper separately.
Otherwise, no point in bundling it.
Exactly. Yeah, so there is a compatibility tool. People are thinking of getting an Oculus Rift. You can still check if your PC is ready for it.
If you've got NVIDIA on your latest drivers, you can have a look and see if it is ready. It will tell you.
That's cool. I think I've got an NVIDIA, but it's a very... It's just going to... Are you insane?
Have you even got USB drives?
He's got a Genesis of NVIDIA, the very first.
Oh, I find that funny. Talking about Genesis, I've heard rumours that people are trying to get Sega to do a Dreamcast 2.
Oh, God. just no.
But then again, we have got a bit of Sega news. Well, when I say Sega news, we've got a bit of Sonic news.
He died.
Sonic's dead. Sonic's dead.
You're going to kill him.
Somebody shot him.
No, it's worse.
What, have you seen the story?
I have.
Do you want to...
It's the same story you were about.
It's a story that's just come out.
Does it involve Sony?
Not sure. I saw the title of it.
Well, if it's the one I'm thinking of, it's that Sega and Sony have teamed up to do a live-action movie.
Yes,
of Sonic.
That's it.
Look at the reaction of Shimmy.
Oh, look at Billy. as Cajr just said, Sonic the Hedgehog is going to be coming to theaters in 2018 in a live action and CGI. Oh, please, let it be the 2006 game.
Sonic Underground Reborn.
I think Billy's probably just died.
Yeah. This is great. Sega Sammy Holdings, the parent company of Sonic the Hedgehog's creator Sega, is working with Sony Pictures to bring the blue blur to the big screen. In an interview with the World Folio, company president and CEO confirmed that a combined live-action and computer-generated film is in the works. So it's going to be Sony Pictures, I like to point out. It's not going to be Sony as in its place.
It's still Sony.
It's still Sony, but yeah.
Do you reckon it'll be like Japanese up and like dead lanky and have like quiff and stuff?
I'm trying to see if it's got anything about it.
I think someone has just been announced. It's not doing nothing about it.
Well, the thing is, this is not the first Sonic movie. There has been Sonic the Movie before, but I think this is the first one that is going to be... I don't understand how they're going to do it live action.
You run really
they'll
fast.
Do like, they'll do like,
I really don't know. Why are they doing this?
It'll be like some 90s films like Space Jam. And yeah, exactly. And did Looney Tunes do one?
There's only one that was very successful out of anything that was a live action. Yeah, Who Framed Roger Rabbit?
Yeah.
That is the best film that did that, and I still we'll go and watch that.
More recent one, Pixels. I said more recent. And I said it was good.
I just said more recent. Sonic's world, isn't it? I don't think he's going to come out in the human realms and everywhere.
I'm looking forward to hearing more about this.
It's going
to
be a guy running around collecting rings.
Look, I've got a feeling Sonic is going to be the CGI Twitter. Part of it.
It's going to be like a weird porno. Give me a ring.
They're just going to
give me a golden ring. I'm going to run into you.
It's going to be Usain Bolt's starring role.
Yeah, Usain Bolt's going to be with that blue spiky wig on. It's going to be like, be your kids, Mark. Come here for your ring.
Oh,
gotta go fast, damn!
It could be worse. They could be doing it with Sonic Boom.
Sonic Boom.
Yeah.
Well, they don't say what they're doing it with.
They haven't actually said.
Oh,
no.
I hope they've got tails in it.
Sonic Underground.
Oh, quite. They've Knuckles. Got to have tails in it.
I hope he gets shot in the face for being useless.
Yeah, by Shadow, which is basically just Sonic in dark
form. Quickly fly off with your little tails. Oh no, I can't.
Robotnik.
That's
Robotnik.
Yeah.
Robotnik's being played by Arnold Schwarzenegger. Swimming caps on. I come to your ring, Sonic. They will be mine.
One minute.
Sonic, give me your ring.
I hear a banging from a far away distance. I think that's Billy. Hitting his head against the wall.
Because he's really excited and wants to see it.
Jimmy's bean.
That's not banging. He's doing something else. He's so excited.
Let's just move away from this, please.
You brought it up.
I know. We both brought it up. To be honest,
you brought it up, and I just knew about it.
So, a Sonic game is going to be coming soon.
Film.
Film, whatever.
That was a golden ring.
Well, there's probably going to be a game with it, knowing them. It'd be for the first spin-off.
The game of the film of the game. Going to be the best.
And it still won't do that good.
I'm just going to have to stream the whole game.
Oculus it.
Let's talk about H1Z1 next. Okay. Where do we begin with this? Sorry?
H1Z1 split into two games.
Yes. I think the best person to talk to us about this a bit would be Dob, because he's the only one who's actually played H1Z1 that I know of. So, why are they splitting up into two games?
Okay, so originally they brought out H1Z1, which got sold quite soon after, actually, didn't it, to a different company?
Yeah, well...
Originally it was supposed to come to Sony, wasn't it?
It was Sony Online Entertainment. And then they sold Sony Online Entertainment to someone else.
And then they became Daybreak?
Yes, Daybreak Studios.
Yeah.
And then... So they brought out H1Z1, which was okay if you could get on the game and actually play it and not get logged out or lagged or pretty much just play. So then they brought out... like a competitive mode, King of the Hill, or whatever it's called. That's what they're going to be calling it. Like a battle royale. There's only your ring, gets smaller and smaller and smaller, you start getting people.
Really successful on DayZ and Armour, isn't it, those games?
Yeah. Yeah, and that's done really well. So they've decided to split the development of the game into two different games. And hopefully one of them will be successful and make them money. And everyone can die a death.
And it's not free to play anymore.
Oh, have you just seen the tweet that he just sent? I'm sorry about this, Doc, but Billy's just sent us a tweet about some leaked footage of the live action Sonic.
Do you know what worries me more?
What?
Billy. Yeah, that came from Billy.
It's from his personal collection.
Is that Billy dressed up?
Probably.
You know what he says? He's old.
Go fast.
He does it weekend, yeah?
No, why? Anyway, let's stick with H1Z1. So, like you said, they're splitting up. I think a lot of people are really upset because They've actually said that they're going to still be charging for both games, aren't they? At about £20 each. Which, when the H1Z1 was first announced, they said that this was going to be a free-to-play game.
You can buy into the early access, but when they bring out, it's going to be free-to-play.
Mm. That's what a lot of people was expecting.
Yeah. Well, that's what they said they were going to do. Now they've changed it, because, you know, the Battle Royale bit is really successful.
Yeah.
And it's on Twitch a lot and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But now they're going to charge for both games and develop them separately. So I don't know if they're taking more people on or they're just splitting the team, which won't do anything more effective.
No. Slow down the production of them both.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, I think that they're mainly wanting to do this because they want to get the Just Survive? Yeah, the Just Survive. They want to get that out on consoles sometime this year. Which completely makes sense. A lot of people, when they first heard H1Z1, they're thinking, oh great, we're going to get a walking simulator coming over to the PlayStation 4 finally. But then
2 years later, we're still waiting.
Yeah, exactly. I think, how many times have you been, I know that you've been asking yourself, Cajr, when is it supposed to be coming out on PlayStation?
Yeah, it was. When it first got announced, it got all the attention it needed, it got at the time, because quite rightly, and then it's just like it faded into the background, and then it just got forgotten. It's like, remember that game H1Z1? When's that coming out? It got to that point where it's like, oh yeah, it was supposed to be coming out. You know, I mean, I know there's loads of games like that that say, oh, we're coming out of this, and then, I mean, on the Xbox, we're still waiting on Quantum Break. You know, that's due for release in coming months. That's coming November, but that's still that. I think that was announced with the console, wasn't it?
Isn't that
for
the PC as well?
Well,
Quantum Break.
I think it is.
It got a PC rating. That got leaked, didn't it?
Yeah. I think it makes sense for it to come out on the PC as well, because it is still a Microsoft product.
Yeah.
And that's what usually Microsoft do. They usually say, oh, it's coming out on consoles and PC too. But it's coming out on the Xbox as a console exclusive.
Yeah, it's like their time exclusive of Tomb Raider.
Tomb Raider is coming out just on Xbox, and it's then going to come out on PlayStation by the end of the year.
Yeah.
But
let me just say though, there's a game that's come out on consoles from PC, and it's also remained free to play.
Yeah,
remained true to the fans, and that game is the Tanks.
Well, that's out on everything now. You're basically doing a Minecraft.
Well, I could actually think there's even another. I think there's another game if you want to go down that route, because I'm sure. Warframe, there's Smite.
Ah, yeah, that's on Xbox only at the moment, and PC of course. It's not on PlayStation yet.
That's shite though.
Oh, get lost!
I'm not playing it. I'm not playing it, so
I can't. On that one.
No, look,
Warframe's supposed to be okay.
It's got a what?
I think the thing about
Warframe's supposed to be good.
I just got confused. The shit out of it.
I had that ruined.
Warframe's like a guesty that's actually good.
I think Smite feels like a girls' game.
What does like Smite feels like a bloody girls' game? Fuck off! At least it's better than certain other games that have MOBAs. I'm not saying which, because I don't want to upset those guys, because they will actually kill me.
You mean which
ones? I don't know which ones you're on about. I don't know which one you're on about. What are you on about?
There's League of Legends.
Yeah, and then there's
Bloater 2.
And something.
Why
couldn't
you make GD say it?
So basically, Heroes of the Storm, League of Legends, and Dota 2.
Heroes of your mum.
I still think Smite's the better one out of them. So I'm going to be honest.
And shite.
I think Smite is the better one just because of its community. No offense.
You can't say that just because you play it. They're all the same community.
They are not the same community. Fuck off. Have you actually gone into a
League of Legends? League of Legends players are tossers.
Exactly. They basically make Call of Duty community look like a bunch of.
But you can't say a game's good just because it's community.
No, you can't.
That's not the defining factor when you say this game's good because the community is good.
No, the
game's got to be good itself, not just the community.
The game is purely online against community players, isn't it? So
yeah, I get that. But the gameplay's still got to be solid. It's still got to be Yeah, you know, yeah.
At its core, it's got to be a good game.
Yeah, but at the same time, you got to think, we said we cannot pick on a game just because of its community. Aren't we the same people who pick on Call of Duty just because of its community? Which we have a certain word just for their community.
Tosses.
Exactly.
Like Counter-Strike's terrible as well.
What was that, Doug?
When I tried Dota 2, like, I was like, oh, I'm new, what do you do? I just got a hell of abuse. That was literally just tons of abuse. And I was just exactly. Alright, all F4, off I go.
Go fuck yourself. Not playing that
we right off the game.
I went on to Counter-Strike Go when I first got that, and I was like, hi, I'm new, can anyone, like, give me any tips?
Kill him! No!
Shimmy, vote to kick Red Shimmy, then, like, 5 votes by Red Shimmy. Using foreign languages.
That's the thing.
It's terrible. Like, get communities like that, the competitive communities.
The actual esports game communities, they can be lethal to new people. They are the things that are going to kill those communities. It is going to be its communities itself. Because they do not allow new people to pretty much break in unless you are good from the get-go.
Basically, you've got to... You can't advertise that you're new. You've got to basically just try and wing it.
Oh, no. They know.
You take the wrong lane. There's 3 lanes. You pick the wrong one. That is it.
You're dead.
Why the hell have you gone this character and you're not jungling? And I'm like, what the hell is jungling? And like, oh,
you're
my God.
You're a noob.
Go and kill yourself. And it's like, oh, my God. What is jungling again?
Yeah, like I said, it makes the Call of Duty community look like... nice people.
Yeah.
There is worse out there, and surprisingly, guess where it comes from? The PCs. That is pretty much what similar to your stupid.
Give me a really, really shit game. A game that was shit. Gameplay and everything.
I played the game yesterday, which I kind of thought was a bit shit.
Infestation Survivor Stories.
Oh, God, yeah, right. That's a perfect one.
Right, let's go with that. So, you say your argument is that a community makes a good game.
Yeah.
But what if that's got a great community, but the game is shit?
Well, tell you what, Gary's Mod, Gmod.
Exactly, that's a great community, but it's a shit game.
Yeah, absolutely.
All the games are, it's just a tool that people have made games using.
In my opinion, if there is a strong enough community and it is a very friendly community, that will make a game great. If the thing is, things like League of Legends, Dota 2, and CSGO, they are great games, but the community is the ones that makes them shit, in my opinion, because they make it so difficult for new people to come in. The thing is, we have heard a lot of people say, oh, I can't get into these because they've already gone right by me. But you still will be able to get into it. For example, like Destiny, that's a good example where Destiny or Call of Duty, there might be people who are already higher up, but you can always easily break in. It's like me, I've not even prestiged in the new Call of Duty yet. But I'm still having fun in it.
Oh, yeah.
But how often do you play it?
Well, I think I played it
yesterday. Often, judging by his gameplay.
Yeah.
and also, when you play it, do you play with the community or you play it with your own party against the community? Like, you're sheltered from the community?
Both. I play with the community and I do play on my own at times.
But when you're playing on your own, are you talking to them all? And
oh, fuck no, I want to talk to those guys.
Exactly, so you're not really engaging with the community, you're just playing alongside them.
But it is nowhere near as toxic as League of Legends, Dota, and
CSGO.
It's nowhere near as toxic. The thing is, with things like Call of Duty, they will still, okay, there is those people who will call you noobs, but they will still give you a bit of a chance. With those ones, they will not give you a chance. They will kick you out as soon as they possibly can.
And you'll be all over the forums, don't play with this guy.
Exactly.
Because he's a chump and all this malarkey, and you'll just say, like, what did I do wrong?
Yeah.
Okay, what? Okay, I took the right lane. Sorry, I took the right lane.
Viola GP, hello. I'm sorry, we're kind in our own ways. I like League of Legends myself. Many hours of night on that game. Never once played the Dota 2. Don't want to be a judge, but it don't look good. Yeah, I agree. Dota 2 doesn't look good. In Dota 2, that is a MOBA itself.
Aren't they just basically the same game?
Sorry? Dota 2 graphics are a bit more...
Don't say that! Do not say that, because that will be...
I'll say it. Aren't they all just basically the same game?
I'm not saying... No, it's a different company.
Yeah, but they do their take on that game. It's like any first-person shooter. But I think with the MOBA, I don't watch it, I don't think so, I don't know, but from what little I've seen, like you say, you've got three lanes. Are they all the three-lane system?
Yeah.
There's only so much you can do with the three-lane system.
No, apparently not. If you get on the wrong one, you're screwed.
Yeah, no, but that's the character. That's
people are sending police around your house because you're doing wrong.
But like I said, they're the same thing. It's a three-lane system and probably similar mechanics within the game.
Before that, Viola, I've got a question for you. How did you actually get into League of Legends? Did you get in... with someone else? Did you get in early, or did you get in with a friend, or things like that?
Recently. Yeah.
Did you have actually a group with you of friends who already were playing that game?
Or is the home for us all yet?
Yeah. Are we all doing?
Not for me, because I'm not even going to attempt.
I did go for a stint of playing Dota 2 a bit, but I didn't want to play with me, so. It was okay, you know. It seems like an easy game on the outside, but every character's different. And like you said, once you those three lanes, that character needs to play it a specific way to get the most for your team. And that's why most people get abused, because they're playing the character wrong. Once you know, you can go out and you can have some, you know, decent fun in it with a team. But it's just getting to that skill level.
Yeah.
The learning curve is quite steep.
Yeah, well, I said,
there's no tolerance nowadays, that's the problem.
No. There is tolerance in a lot of games, it's just unfortunately there's certain games that are known for not being tolerant. Oh. And it does hurt its game's image, especially when they're trying to be classed as sports as well.
It started from a Twitch stream.
Seen on Twitch.
Yeah. That's okay. Don't think the game is too famous. That's probably why. Yeah.
Sure.
I think it's a huge game, especially in the US and South Korea.
Yeah.
It's basically.
I think South Korea's become the unofficial gaming capital, competitive gaming capital of the world, hasn't it?
I think it's national sport.
I'm not joking, I think it's actually
it's national sport now.
Koreans are good, aren't they?
Oh god, that's what you seen. I was watching
the best gamers and the worst bad guys.
Yeah.
Are you thinking of North Korea again?
I was going to say, are you thinking of North Korea with the bad guys thing? And the silence is deafening.
Shimmy? What? Are you thinking of North Korea again?
Yeah, North Korea, the bad guys, that's what I mean. But it's still Korea, isn't it? North Korea is the...
They're two separate countries, mate.
Are they not both Korea, just...
No, they're two separate countries. It's like...
It's like North... It's like East and West.
It's like East and West...
They were two separate countries when they were East Germany, one called West Germany.
They're not a unified country. Because the Russians are the East and the...
It was one country and it's split, isn't it?
It was one country, but now it's two countries.
But it's the same place. It's the same place. It's like saying bloody
way. Isn't it? Because North Korea is...
It's the UK.
I love it. The Viola can't understand the word you're saying, Catch.
Hitler is gay. That's a good name.
Anyway, I think we're getting...
Too much English.
Yeah, I think we're getting closer to the end of the podcast, guys.
Which,
by the way, people who are in Twitch chat, stay around to the end because we are going to be doing a giveaway today of Far Cry 3.
Oh, yeah.
I speak perfect English.
Sure you do, mate.
Perfect
So yeah, a few quick updates. Pokemon has got newest legendary creature will be coming debuting this summer. It will be number 722 in the Pokemon's life cycles. And courtesy of the next issue of Japanese magazine Kurokuro, Magiana joins the lengthy roster as the franchise's next legendary. What is it? Not much is known about it yet. More details will be shared when the magazine hits newsstands. What we do know, however, is that the Pokemon is classified as man-made, having been deliberately created by humans.
It's basically another Polygon Mewtwo kind of...
Yeah, but this was...
Babymon!
How the fuck do you create a Pokemon? It's supposed to be a living thing. Supposed to be everything in that world is a Pokemon.
When even the fucking loves the mummy,
the worms.
It's man made.
Well, just make it a robot.
It is a robot. Yeah, it's a robot. By the looks of things, it's a robot. It looks like a bunny robot.
If a pair of keys can be a Pokemon, it's
there's
yeah,
that's
no
a good point. If a pair of keys can be, and a chandelier.
Yeah, that's just they're just hiding. They just don't want to be seen. Don't want to be caught and put into a Pokeball.
Look, this is the first time I've heard that a pair of keys actually be called a fairy. And that is because of Pokemon. By the way, I have huge respect for Pokemon, who is reaching its 20th anniversary at the end of the month.
Has it been that long?
Yeah, 20 years.
And Ash is still 10 years old.
Yeah, it's creeping me out.
And he's still not caught them all. The entire tagline has got to catch them all. And he's caught about...
He's got to be the shittest Pokemon trainer.
The only thing he's caught is syphilis from Misty.
Ash, the shittest Pokemon trainer we all know.
Yeah, the entire tagline of the TV show is gotta catch them all.
And he doesn't. He meets them, but doesn't catch them.
No. Catches one every, 10 episodes or something.
And then he'll get to the end of the whole series and be like, oh, shit, I done it wrong.
I've lost my Pokedex.
Do you reckon at the end, when they finish the entire series, it'll just go on a massive catching spree? Like every Pokemon it can find, it'll just catch them all. And then it'll just say, ha, I caught them all.
Oh, we realise Brock is a Pokemon, catches him.
Anyway, moving on, this is supposed to be the quick update. Rocket League is going to be coming on Xbox One next week. So, well done. You're getting Rocket League, which we all already have. So, yay, Rocket League, I guess. Thanks for the quiet, guys.
Yay,
I've got it on PlayStation 4.
Well, people who haven't got it, it is going to be hitting on February the 17th, which is a week today.
Yeah.
It will. New Rocket League fans of Xbox One will get some bonuses for their patience. Three of the game's downloadable add-ons will be included as part of a $20 package. So they're going to get all the stuff that we have to pay for on PlayStation and the PC.
Yeah, but it's only £14 on the Play. Well, it's free for us.
It was free for that period. It's not free anymore. When they brought it out, it was free.
Yeah, and also Xbox One players will also get a few console exclusive cars: the Armadillo from Gears of War and the Hog Sticker Warthog variant from Halo. So
I knew they'd be included. It'll be.
Yeah, and they'll also get some Sunset Overdrive inspired cosmetic items as well.
Yeah.
Yay. What's on your shirt, by the way, GD? Is it a pirate?
Pirate Ninja.
It's on his head.
That's
rain, isn't it?
No, it's like a word art thing. You know, like the Gentleman Creeper that I've got.
I can see Rogue, Outlaw.
Yeah. It's a word art version of it.
Fighter.
Yeah. Is it that was supposed to be like smoke coming out of his head or his brain or something?
No, it's supposed to be a hat. That's supposed to be a hat. So it's basically caught between...
Oh, in half.
Yeah,
oh,
so you've got
see,
ninja,
the ninja side.
Ninja that side, and you've got pirate that side.
Ah, I get it now.
Yeah, so it's ninja versus pirate. Which side are you guys on, ninja or pirate?
Ninja.
Pirate. So I'm getting pirate.
I'm a ninja. Ooh. continuing on anyway. I hate looking for this. Oh, Overwatch's closed beta is back with some big changes. So people who are able to get into the... Thank you. Yes, loot crate. People who are missing Overwatch who have played the closed beta, it's back open again for you guys to go and play some more Overwatch, which I am not part of. I don't think my PC would be able to run that anyway.
Just Team Fortress 2, isn't it?
Sherlock Holmes meets the Devil's Daughter this spring. So that is the new Sherlock Holmes game. We ended up playing, what was it called again? Crimes and Punishments. Which
yeah.
turned out it was actually one of the great game in the end, which I was actually very surprised about.
That's being played right behind me right now.
Yeah, it's what, really?
Yeah.
Great game, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah, so Sherlock Holmes and the Devil's Daughter is going to be arriving on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and PC on May the 27th. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I'm hoping it's just going to, if anything, be pretty much similar to the last one that came out. So, yay. Well, talking about that, there's an Agatha Christie one that came out this week as well, which...
The ABC murders.
Yeah, I might have a look into that, actually. The Division Open Beta launches next week. Me and Cajr played a bit of it when it was closed beta. I think you did as well, didn't you, Doc?
I've got about 13 hours.
That is more than a bit.
What do you think? Is it open for you? What happens when the game comes out? You get
open betas for anyone.
Yeah, it's open beta. So Ubisoft is launching an open beta for Tom Clancy's The Division.
Is it free?
The beta will begin on February the 18th as a one-day exclusive for Xbox One owners. PS4 and Windows PC gamers will have access starting the following day on February the 19th.
One day?
No, it runs on the weekend. They get a day early.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. But yeah, I think it is open to everybody. That's the point of it being called an open beta. So I've got it's just going to be the stuff that we managed to play.
There might be a few. I think they've actually said that the Dark Souls is going to be much harder.
Ooh.
Yeah, and they've got rid of most of the cheating now as well.
Well, there was rumours about the actual, what's it called? The PC version, because it kept on getting hacked, didn't it?
Mm.
I think they said that they didn't actually have the anti-cheat program running during the beta.
Which makes perfect sense. Because now the people have told them how they've done it.
Yeah.
They can go, well, that's easy. Da-da-da-da-da. Turn this back on. Sorted. Yeah.
And then when it comes to the game, this is how we... I can't do it. I have now been kicked out of the game. Oh, shit.
Yeah, exactly.
£50 well spent.
Mm. But no, it's a really good game, so anyone who's not played it, I'd definitely recommend it.
Well, talking about... Yeah, talking about an anti-cheat software... There was a certain game that someone talked about a mod that you could cheat in it. And then it turned out.
I think it told you.
Yeah, what was it again?
I don't know, it was Counter-Strike Go.
Counter-Strike Go, that you could actually.
Somebody made a mod which kept bringing up kill boxes and all that so people could cheat. But I think it released three, and the first two, after a week, they started basically making it clear that they were cheating. Like, for some people, the camera would be at an angle like that, and then they'd have infinite ammo, infinite health, all that. So basically, whatever server run, it was shut flagging up. And then the third one he released, instantly, it was like infinite ammo, so they got banned instantly. I think he got about 5,000 people.
So yeah. Basically,
he's done on purpose.
Yeah, pretty much.
He's done it on purpose to catch people out.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
And you're all calling the Counter-Strike community when one person does that.
Yeah, I like to point out I'm still calling them.
Yeah, but that one person, 4,000 people that wanted to, 4,000 people wanted to cheat, and one person wanted to stop them.
Yeah,
big contrast. And I've cheated myself on games. So.
Anyway, Final Fantasy IX is now out on mobile. So.
I was thinking about this as well.
What?
Didn't they do that with Final Fantasy VII before it eventually came to PS4?
Yeah, they did.
So does that, if we're following this through,
Final Fantasy IX will probably be out by the end of the year.
It was similar time this year. This time, no, it was after E3, weren't it?
So they actually came out on E3 and said, yeah, it's going to be coming out. We're just going to put mobile in the middle of it here, and we're just going to push the PS4 version port that way. I'm just remembering Cajr's anger because they did that.
I still actually have my original 9 PS1 somewhere.
Anyway, Amazon has rolls out Lumberyard, an entirely free game development engine.
That'll be shit then.
I don't know. It's.
No, I don't know. They've got the money.
Yeah. Well, it's just joining things like Unreal and. Crytek. It's actually based on the Crytek engine a bit in the end.
Final Fantasy IX. Yeah. Mint condition as well.
Nice. As he drops it.
Yeah.
I still got a PS2 somewhere to play it on.
In about an inch of dust on the top of that then.
No, it's a bit middle of a pack, so there's no dust on top of it.
The best Pokemon movie is now streaming online for free. The first movie is so you can watch it on Pokemon TV. Switch.
Pokemon TV.
Do you know what I'm going to be doing?
Is that the one where Ash died?
Yeah, it's the one with Ash dying in it. Spoiler.
Oh, you
shit! Oh god. Oh no.
And you had all the dark Pokemon.
Okay, can we not talk about this because it's a good movie. People actually want to watch it.
What did they name the second one? We're at 2000. They didn't actually name it number 2,
yeah,
did they?
Yeah, they called it 2000. That was the one with...
I don't really watch it. I've grown out of Pokemon fans by then.
Yeah. There's 13 movies.
Yeah, but they were all based around legendaries though, weren't they?
Yeah. Yeah, basically they did a movie and then launched the legendary. That's what they did. So expect a new movie with this new legendary. Where they're probably actually building it.
It's going to be Sonic.
Yeah, watch Pikachu's, yeah. That's a good point. Go and watch it just to watch Pikachu, two Pikachus slapping each other. Pokken Tournament has use for all your amiibos. I doubt it. Oh, yeah, that's something we didn't talk about. Microsoft, the Red Dead Redemption shown up as a backwards compatible game earlier this week, and then was took off straight away. What it was is Microsoft said that they've got a testing server, which accidentally went into public domain. So it wasn't just Red Dead Redemption. There was quite a few games that shown up in that list. If I can find, it doesn't actually say what games were there.
It's the only one that people care about.
No. There was Halo Wars, Castlevania Symphony of the Night, and Tekken Tag Tournament 2. And there was another game, but I don't remember what it was. Either way, they accidentally...
Well, Black Ops?
No, it wasn't Black Ops. It was a game that... I don't remember. People will find it. But either way, they accidentally came up in as backwards compatible to people, and it was taken down straight away. So it's nice to see that they are being tested, these games.
Yeah, but they said there won't be a monthly release now, will they? It's no, based as and when.
They're going to be released. As soon as they're ready, they will be released. Which, at the same time, I like the idea, but at the same time, I don't. Because it was nice.
You never know when.
Exactly.
But we never had a set date, though. That's the thing.
It was usually the last week of the month.
Yeah, but wasn't a set day. Wasn't a set, right, on the 24th of this month, every month, there will be the backwards compatibility day.
No, I think they said that it was a set date at the end of the month.
Yeah, but like I say, I prefer it as long as they advertise it, as long as they don't just say,
oh yeah, at least
just
tell
put
us
it up there.
Time.
Like, put.
Let's talk about it. That's what we ask for. But I doubt they'll do that. Apple. They rejected the Binding of Isaac Rebirth because of violence towards children. Now, I'd like to point out this is the same Apple that allowed games like Limbo, which, guess what? You kill a little boy in that game. Okay, it's a shadow, but he still dies.
So, it's not really abuse, you're just putting out of his misery, aren't you?
Yeah, pretty much. they've said that they're not allowing it. I'm thinking...
I'm sure there's a lot
Do you guys
worse.
Really... There's yeah. enough systems that have the game already.
I think, you know, maybe they're just worried that kids are going to get hold of it.
Yeah, because you got to think Apple, where a lot of kids will use the parents' iPod, iPad, iPhone.
Why is that mummy beating up that child and killing him, taking it closer to God?
What did he do to his eyes?
Or maybe they're scared some mum's going to play it and want to kill their kid to get closer to God or something like that.
Well, at least release it in the UK then. You don't have to release it in the US.
Not in America.
No, they'll say no offence to them, but... so don't expect Binding of Isaac to be coming to the Apple store anytime soon. I think they had the same problem with Nintendo, but theirs was because of religious reasons, Nintendo do not allow religious any kind of religious tone in a game.
Because they are their own religion.
Pretty much, yeah. Nintendo is a religion.
Work for Nintendo, you worship Nintendo.
Let's be honest, really. You know, if you do own anything made by Apple, you've got to be a complete tosser.
Fuck off.
Are you just throwing that word out today? That's about the third time you've used it.
It's my word of the day.
Shimmy's word of the day.
Tosser.
Because we've been talking about Call of Duty, that's why.
I think because of, like I say, iPhones and iPads, because a lot of parents will have their bank details on it,
yeah.
And especially you see all these stories of children buying shit they don't need.
Thousand Candy Crush lives.
The chance of them getting Binding of Isaac will be quite high, especially when it's first released. Because it'll be like, click on that. I mean, my son sometimes gets that, but we don't have bank details in it, but it'll just, on YouTube, it'll just go in anywhere. Ends up on something quite violent, and I'm listening to him thinking, turn that off. Because he's just pressing things.
Yeah. So,
Apple allow, like, San Andreas and stuff like that on their devices.
Exactly. So there is games that are, it's just because of the child abuse. So it's something to do with their,
What is the child abuse? It's a freaking game with a baby that kills things with its eyeballs.
The main character's supposed to be a child. That's what the main...
Oh, it's a baby, isn't it?
Yeah, because you run away from your mum, aren't you?
Yeah.
Well, there's an easy solution. Don't get caught.
Don't get caught doing drugs.
So the child gets hurt.
So don't go crazy over religion.
Like, take it easy. Could be members of ISIS watching this. Or ISIS, whatever the fuck.
Well, I didn't take it down that route. I wasn't even thinking about that route.
You mentioned it. Some people take religion too seriously.
Well,
funny story for you. I was at work the other day. And I was having a cigarette outside, and this Jehovah's Witness come up to me. No, we're Jehovah's Witnesses. And he was saying, like, God's going to come back to Earth and stuff like that. And then he was like, and he's like, God's going to come back to Earth and, like, rule over, which is, you know, that happens. And he was like, I was like, why has he not done it yet? That was the other question. And he was like, well, you know, because of Adam's ate from the sacred tree or whatever, you know, we're all living in sin because of that. He's going to come down when he feels ready. He was like, you know, it's like a child not really, what was it he said? He was like, oh, it's like a child, you know, you got your house and you run it your way and your child wants to do it a different way. So I just turned around. I was like, what? You mean like Carl ran out of the Force Awakens? And he just looked at me so confused and walked off.
You should try and convert him into a Jedi.
Yeah. I was just like, don't answer my question then. This is not fair.
That's the first time I've actually heard a Jehovah's Witness actually walk away from somebody.
I think I just asked him too many questions, and he just didn't
Anyway, other things. The Walking Dead, Michonne, is going to be launching on consoles and PC on February the 23rd. That is the special three-part Telltale game, which stars Michonne from the actual TV series. Not Michonne Pfeiffer, no. All the episodes will cost about $15. An iOS and Android version of the series will launch February the 25th. That's another thing. Talking about no child abuse in the game. Walking Dead, the Telltale game. For crying out loud, how many times have you hurt Clementine in the second season?
Yeah, but you don't physically hurt it yourself, do you?
You have to control it, yes.
Off camera.
But it's not as if you put cigarettes on your arm.
What about that ladder that's in the first one that dies? I forgot his name.
Oh, yeah, Duck.
Duck, yeah.
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 Yeah, but he was a tosser anyway.
Don't start changing the rules just because you don't like a game.
Depends how graphic it is, though. How I mean, I've not finished.
But it can be quite a bit graphic.
I shot Duck in his stupid face.
You shot Duck?
Yeah.
Oh, I did shoot.
On the tractor, I regretted, but he's. Oh, I'm not even going to say it. I'm a spoiler, isn't it?
Yeah, no.
But I regretted.
A bit late now. We've kind of given away. Duck dies.
Oh, come on! The game has been out now for how many years? Yeah, come on.
Yeah, I wish I'd left him on there. I wish you got eaten on the tractor.
Right, are you guys got any other news stories that you want to talk about before we move on to the next couple of bits?
No.
No.
Okay. I'd like to find out answer the Jehovah's Witness that spoke to Dark Claw.
Yeah, they're
dead. Where is he now?
I'm going to watch Star Wars to see what I'm on.
I bet he thought, fucking weirdo, and just walked off.
The Hitman beta. There's a Hitman beta coming up.
Oh, yeah. There's also the Homefront beta starting soon as well.
Yeah, I don't know when that is. I signed up for it.
Bombit, have you actually been given a code for it yet, mate?
Not yet. No. Unless it's in my spam folder and my email, but.
I signed up to it about 2 or 3 hours ago. Signed up, they gave me a code straight away.
What's that for? Oh, the beta, yeah.
Yeah. But then again, I went through. I've got connections in the. What's it called? So they managed to get me a code straight away without, sorry.
That's why I'm going to be playing this weekend.
Hopefully. Yay.
Got like 50,000 coins on it now.
On Plantera?
Yeah.
I was talking to the actual, I'm not 100% sure, but that game needs to be on a certain system, doesn't it?
What do you mean?
A sort of tablet version of the system.
Yeah.
Yeah, they I've heard rumors that they are on about trying to get that game onto there. But by the way, we're talking about Plantera, which you can actually go onto our YouTube channel.
I saw you playing that the other day.
Yeah, youtube.com/CraveYourGames. Yeah, me and Shimmy was talking. We did a bit of Would You Press the Button as well while we were playing that. But yeah, it's a fun game. It's a great casual game, especially for about £2. I'd always advise at least go and play it.
Damn foxes pinching your chickens.
Fucking foxes.
And what do the moles do though? The moles just pop up, don't they?
They just pop up and give you coins if you hit them.
Yeah, it was in the spam folder.
It was in your spam folder, so you've got a code. Yeah. That's cool. Yeah. That's something. Nintendo's reward program and mobile app is launching in March, which is going to be the first game from with the DNA partnership. Which is the, where is it? Miitomo. So that will be available in March in Japan first, of course, and 39 other countries throughout North America, Europe, Japan, Russia, South Africa, Australia, New Zealand. This doing the two different reward points is gold and platinum. We get platinum for just going into the app and stuff like that. And then you get gold for playing games, and gold is earned by purchasing content from the eShop. So that's supposed to be replacing the Club Nintendo stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Lego Star Wars, The Force Awakens is going to be coming June. So they are going to be doing the new movie throughout that game, yeah. And they're also supposed to be bridging the gap between the sixth and mm-hmm. seventh movie.
It's expanded.
Yeah. So
there is also a comic book series out.
Yeah, but this is Lego. This is
bad. Yeah, but the comic book series is going to be discussing the how C-3PO got his arm. That's the only way they're going to find out how 3PO got his red arm.
Yeah.
No. There was one come out before the film was released.
It turns out that he's actually from Metal Gear Solid 5.
Solid Snake.
Thank you.
Snake. It's not Solid Snake, is it?
Yeah.
I don't think it makes sense.
Anyway, yeah, that's all the stories that we've got here anyway. So the UK game charts, after slipping down to number 2 last week, Activision Blizzard's Call of Duty Black Ops 3 has taken back the top spot on the UK charts once again, pushing Warner Brothers' Lego Marvel Avengers down one place to number 2 after 1 week. Highest new release this week goes to Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm 4, who debuts at number 3. Yeah, that was a mouthful. Pushing FIFA 16 and Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege down one place to numbers 4 and 5. Grand Theft Auto 5 keeps hold of number 6 as Star Wars Battlefront drops two places down to 7, and Just Cause 3 down one place to number 8. The biggest mover this week goes to Assassin's Creed Syndicate, moving up 11 places from 9 from 20, with Minecraft Story Mode moving into the top 10 at number 10. Other new releases who just miss out the top 10 are Digimon Story Cyber Sleuth debuting at number 11 and the PC exclusive XCOM 2 debuting at number 20.
Okay.
Now, I'd like to point out this chart is retail. They're not digital. Yeah. I've got a feeling it'd be different because that's where a lot of people would have got XCOM 2 from. Mm. So XCOM 2 did sell really well.
Is XCOM not going onto console at all, though?
I've heard it's not coming on consoles at all at the moment.
Oh.
Well, it's like the game itself. You can use a gamepad, but it'll only work with the Steam gamepad. It will not work with an Xbox gamepad, which is stupid. So number 5, Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege, 4, FIFA 16, 3, Naruto Shippuden, 2, Lego Marvel Avengers, and back at number 1, Call of Duty Black Ops 3. So, before we move on to the game releases, let's do our usual stuff. Streams, game nights. Let's start with you, Doc. Any streams planned? Any game nights planned?
There will be some, I just don't know when.
You don't know when?
I might do a bit of a... stream bit of naval action tomorrow, actually.
Yeah, explain to me what the hell that is, because I saw you playing it.
Basically an Age of Sail simulator. It's kind of like the same combat from Black Flag, ship combat, okay. In a massive open world.
Does look decent, actually.
It's quite addictive, actually. It's really good.
So, when Doc is doing any streams, you can find him at twitch.tv/docrobin87. It's the same as his Twitter handle as well. So follow him. He does some great streams, I promise you. Talking about that, we might be thinking of doing a tabletop simulator game soon as well.
Now we need to do that.
Yes. You got that game yet, Doc?
Yeah.
Not yet.
I know. Yeah.
Anyway.
And if I'm not working. No.
Yeah, cool. Shimmy, what about you, mate? Any streams, game nights? You're going to play some Platera?
Yeah, I might put some of that up just for the lols. I've been playing that Rainbow Six Siege, quite a few of them up.
That's brilliant game.
It's decent. I like doing the terrorist hunt.
Don't talk about
that. That's per the multiplayer.
This is just a good game at GD's anyone will get about two months ago.
Get it! I'm sorry, I haven't got it yet.
Get it and we'll play, for God's sake.
I'll take you again on Xbox, aren't you?
Sort your life. Yeah, I got it on the...
Xbox.
So, I think I'm going to do some more of that.
You can catch Shimmy at twitch.tv/redshimmy. Same with his Twitter handle, Shimmy. So
yeah.
Cajr, what about you, mate? Any game nights planned? Any streams?
No, since implants. No.
You're back to normal work again.
No, it's not that. It's me. You've known GD. They've been having problems with me Twitch stream. It seems audio problems. I don't know what the problem is.
No. It's nowhere near as bad as.
Basically, I'm stuck at PS4.
Yeah, which isn't a bad thing.
Well, the Mass Effect odds to play on Xbox.
Well, we technically haven't tried a backwards compatible game. You tried Tharsis, which came out yesterday on our YouTube channel.
Oh, YouTube, yeah, I guess, yeah.
Yeah.
But that's on PS4 anyway.
You did play on PS4, didn't you? So technically,
but I've had problems when I've been trying to stream, because we do try to stream, although we did it last week. Was it GTA?
No, it was something else.
There was something I tried to stream anyway.
Something I was streaming, but you couldn't. Oh, Division.
Yeah, and what it were, my recommended quality was 400 kps, and the low was 800 kps.
In other words, his console was pretty much trying to tell him, "Don't fucking stream."
How bad is your internet then?
Must be shite.
Anyway, if Cajr is doing any stream, you can catch him at twitch.tv/CAJR87, same as his Twitter handle at CAJR87. For me, this Sunday, we are going to be doing a games night. Which game night? I don't know yet. So it could be a Jackbox game, but I am actually trying to see if we can get a Cards Against Humanity working.
You can play that on
we can play it on
Tabletop Simulator.
I know we can play it on there, but I want to try and play it so that we can get people to join us. You want to play it on Tabletop Simulator? Expect to see a Tabletop Simulator very, very soon.
I play Uno or something, yeah.
Yeah, we want to test it as well, yeah. So expect to see something like that soon. I will be doing some streams. I don't know what yet. Expect one on Friday. Not sure I'm streaming yet, but I will be streaming at 9 p.m. again. But you can catch me at twitch.tv/GDW2507. I did actually, yeah, a little bit then. Same with my Twitter handle at GDW2007. You can also catch us every Wednesday on the podcast by following us on here, twitch.tv/CTG podcast. I'll also follow Crave Your Game on Twitter at Crave Your Game. Our YouTube channel, said it so many times now, youtube.com/Crave Your Games. For the audio version of the podcast and the updates, you can find those at craveyourgame.wordpress.com. And for a friendly community, as long as you're 18 and over, you can join us where we all come from, cravethegame.net. Usually that's where we put our game nights if we are doing a huge community one. Expect us to be putting more stuff there in future as well. Game releases. Billy, have you got anything you'll probably... What is he streaming? Undertale? I think it's Undertale on Thursday for Billy. More than likely. Yeah.
I think Billy died because he kind of...
He was there a minute ago.
It was ever since Sonic.
Yeah, he's... Oh, God, it's actually, really? It did mention
something about Star Wars. Han Solo.
So, aren't they making the film between 3 and 4 about young Han Solo? Yeah, they're also doing a Rebels one, which is supposed to be coming out this year.
Rogue One.
Rogue, thank you. Sorry.
Rogue One.
Rogue One, yeah, where this stealing the...
That's going to be canon.
Yeah, this is canon, this one is. Every film that is going to be coming out now will be canon.
But all films were canon, it's just the books which weren't canon.
Yeah.
And the games.
Did you read how much Star Wars made Disney last year?
It's
probably a stupidly
how
amount
of money. How could the films be canon but the books not when the books were first?
Because the books have been put into the expanded universe. Because basically, if you want to go off what's canon and what isn't, if you go off the books, Chewbacca would already be dead.
Yeah, so Chewbacca being alive is non-canon. Because the books.
No, it is canon because the books have been. I'd like to point out.
Let's not start talking about Star Wars because it's boring.
Before they watched Star Wars, they made a list of what's canon and what's not.
They did, yeah. I don't know what it is anymore. My hair's going to be.
I've not watched the new Star Wars because it's a lot of crap.
Me either.
Yeah.
I'll be getting it when it comes out on DVD.
Anyway, game releases for the week. So, games that came out yesterday, we had Firewatch, which came out on the PS4 and PC digital only. Unravel is available on Xbox One, PS4, and PC digital only. I've played a bit of a. Oh, yeah, by the way, if you've got EA Access, you can play a trial of Unravel to have a go of it. I've managed to. It's actually an alright game. What I've played.
Have EA Access?
EA Access. I've got EA Access, yeah. I haven't got the Origin one. I've got the Xbox one.
I bet you play Madden all the time.
I played it once. I played it twice, technically, because I played a game against Cajr, which we've got on our channel.
I've not seen it. I'll have to go and chase off.
Yeah, you learned. I'm shit. I do not know anything about American football.
Did anyone actually watch the Super Bowl?
Yeah, I did watch a bit.
American football
me,
is
it me or
ridiculous.
Is Doc's camera kind of froze?
Doc?
Is he trying to talk to us and we can't hear him?
Doc's in a good voice, though. Yeah. And a good position.
I was going to say, he's not putting a stupid face, is he, Shimmy?
No.
Anyway,
but yeah, I watched the Super Bowl.
Yeah, Dying Light, the following. It came out on PC on Tuesday, digital only. Assassin's Creed Chronicles Russia, which is the last part of the Chronicles series, is out on Xbox One, PS4, and PC. And Lovers in a Dangerous Space Time is out on PS4. Thursday, the 11th February, Oddworld New and Tasty comes out on the Wii U, digital only.
Someone took him 2 years.
Games coming out on Friday the 12th of February. So we've got Dying Light the following, coming out on Xbox One, PS4, and PC. That's the retail version of it. Yep. Earth Defense Force 4.1, The Shadows of New Despair, comes out on the PS4. Bye, Doc.
You're slowly fading away.
Yeah, I really hope we can connect.
A David Bowie album cover.
Doc?
At least my internet might be shit, but at least I don't disconnect.
Hey, he's back. I think.
Yeah.
Earth Defense Force 2, Invaders from Planet Space, comes out on the Vita. So there's two Earth Defense games coming out.
Yay!
Yeah. Etrian Odyssey 2 Untold, The Fafnir Knight, comes out on the 3DS. Arslan, The Warrior of Legend, comes out on the Xbox One and PS4. Mega Dimension Neptunia 7 comes out on PS4. Swear to God, where are they thinking these names? Alec Hines Gun comes out on the Xbox One, PS4, PC. Terraria comes out on the 3DS.
Ooh.
And Gone Home comes out on the Xbox One and PS4, digital only. Is that the one?
Let's try it out today.
Sorry?
Tomorrow. This week.
That's coming out on Friday, yeah.
I get that.
On 3DS, that is.
Yeah.
And then games coming out Tuesday, the 16th February. We've got Street Fighter V coming out on PS4 and PC. That is not coming out on Xbox One at all. It's a PS4 console exclusive.
What's that, sorry? All right, listen.
Street Fighter V.
All right. Well, yeah. That's probably why I won't listen.
Yeah. Layers of Fear comes out of the preview program on Tuesday, the 16th as well, on Xbox One. And it will also be available on the PS4 and PC. So it comes out of Early Access and the Preview Program. Tron Run comes out on the Xbox One, PS4, and PC. And The Escapist, The Walking Dead Edition, comes out on the PS4 as a retail copy. So yeah, that's all the games coming out this week. Anything that catches your guys' interest?
Eventually, but not just yet.
I might want to play the Dying Light one, actually.
I think for me it might be the Firewatch. I'm interested in that. I'll look into it first, though.
Yeah, well, that's already available on the PS4.
Yeah, I know.
So, I would say Dying Light, the following's kind of got me interested, because I find it weird that we're having such a big update for a game that is over a year, that is coming up to about a year old now.
Yeah.
Which is, by the way, it's one of the most underrated games of last year.
I think they've done it instead of doing a sequel, haven't they?
Yeah, This is basically
a sequel. Yeah, it's basically a sequel because it's a completely new area. There's vehicles and all that crap. but it's just basically the sequel.
I think they said that there's buggies because the area that you're going into, there's barely any buildings, so you haven't got much of the parkour.
It's mostly fields.
Yeah. But still, I'm going to probably have a go of that. That's what I'll probably be playing on Friday. So keep an eye out for that. That is the podcast for this week. Like I said, people who are watching this on Twitch live, stick around to the end because of the giveaway. And, people, YouTube, I can't think of finishing this. Shimmy, do you want to finish the podcast for me, please, mate?
In a long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, there was a doc, and he scared a Jehovah's Witness through the story. And we found this out on this podcast, and there's loads of other good stuff you can find out on this podcast. So we've had fun, guys. Cheers.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Bye.
Yeah, see you guys.
Bye.
People want it more. It's like a publicity system.
It's next Goat Simulator.
it could just be a publicity stunt. Like, a couple months down the line, he ends up back at the studio quietly, and then release Anthony Simulator thinking, remember that game we all followed about? Here it is.
Yeah, there you go. Enjoy.
People have heard of it now. Like you say, you'd never heard of it before this. A lot of people wouldn't have heard of it. I never heard it before this.
Oh, that's what I was thinking with Billy here, going, I'll make my own game with booze and strippers. In fact, forget the whole game.
Yeah, forget the game. Just get the booze and the strippers.